G'day, I'm Jesse Crowe, the travelling scientist, and today we're going to be looking at antibiotics, answering three key questions. How do antibiotics work? What's the deal with antibiotic resistance? And can you drink alcohol while you're on antibiotics? Antibiotics are a type of drug that are used to treat bacterial infections, and there's many different types. There's beta-lactams, which target the bacteria's cell wall synthesis. So when bacteria can't produce the cell wall, they kind of just explode. There's macrolides and tetracyclines. They stop the bacteria from producing the proteins that they need to live. There's sulphonamides, which stop the bacteria from producing folate, which it also needs to live. And then there's fluoroquinolones, which target bacterial DNA replication, so the bacteria can't divide and reproduce. Fun fact, most bacteria are actually good for you. In fact, 90% of the cells in your body aren't even your own. They're bacterial cells. In your gut, in your mouth, on your skin, there's bacteria everywhere. But the bacterial cells are really small, so you can't really tell. When you become infected with a bad kind of bacteria, a doctor should be able to prescribe a specific antibiotic to treat your bacterial infection, depending on what sort of bacteria it is. See, there's lots of different kinds of bacteria, each with their own strengths and weaknesses. Kind of like different characters in a video game. Different types of antibiotics can be utilized to kill different types of bacteria. But there's a serious problem here.
Bacteria fight back.
When bacteria are exposed to a certain antibiotic, usually they die. But sometimes a bacteria might mutate and become resistant to that antibiotic. For example, some bacteria can produce a protein that actually pumps the antibiotic out of the bacterium before it becomes effective. These antibiotic-resistant bacteria then grow and divide, creating a whole new colony of antibiotic-resistant bacteria. But wait, there's more. Bacteria are able to share these resistance genes by a process called conjugation. So if one bacterium is resistant to, say, sulfonamides, and another bacterium is resistant to beta-lactams, those two bacteria could potentially meet up and share those resistance genes, producing multiply resistant bacteria. Superbugs. So humans keep developing more effective antibiotics and bacteria keep becoming more resistant to them. And the arms race continues. But the question is, what's going to happen when we run out of antibiotic ideas? Will there be some multiply resistant super strain of bacteria that's going to infect the whole world and kill everybody? Probably.
Jesus!
But I guess all you can do is try not to take antibiotics unless you really need them. Just be aware, I mean, most antibiotic prescriptions from doctors are ineffective. Most people are usually infected with a virus or they're just a little bit sick. You don't need antibiotics to treat everything. You're just helping produce more antibiotic-resistant bacteria. Don't take antibiotics unless you know you need them. And if you do have to take antibiotics, make sure you take all of them. Hopefully the full script is enough to kill the bacterial infection that you have. If you only take a few and then you stop, you're more likely to produce antibiotic-resistant bacteria, which is bad. But now for the question you've all been waiting for. Can you drink alcohol while you're taking antibiotics? I mean, the doctor says no, and the box says no, but your heart says yes. Have a beer, mate. Ah, I can't, I'm on antibiotics. You change, man. You used to be cool. But I really want a beer. The doctor says I can't drink on antibiotics. Your doctor's wrong. Here's what the traveling scientist has to say. So if you take antibiotics and alcohol at the same time, they're both going to be metabolized a little bit slower. The reason is that some antibiotics are metabolized in the liver by an enzyme called cytochrome P450, the same enzyme that also metabolizes alcohol in the liver, which means you get a little more drunk and your antibiotics might be slightly less effective for just a few hours. Cheap to get pissed, right? And there's no real major health concerns. Unless you're drinking for the entire time you're on antibiotics and your dosage level never gets high enough to defeat the bacterial infection, and then it mutates into some kind of superbug that spreads across the globe and infects the entire population, dooming us all. But you wouldn't do that, would you? Nah. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, click the like button down below. And if you have any questions or comments about antibiotics, let us know in the comment section down below. Next week's video is going to be all about the science of antidepressants, so definitely check that out. And make sure you subscribe for more traveling science every week. I'll see you guys next time. Cheers.